A new study published Tuesday in the scientific journal Geology links the magnitude 5.6 earthquake that hit Oklahoma in November 2011 to natural gas drilling operations nearby that were using an extraction technique called fracking. Of course, who didn't see this coming? And of course, fracking requires massive amounts of wastewater to be injected into underground reservoirs. And this new study is basically saying that that's what led to that particular earthquake. And if we continue to do fracking all around the United States, the same thing will happen. There will be more and more earthquakes. So we've discussed fracking before. And what they do is they drill deep underground through shale rock to tap natural gas reservoirs. But in order to get the natural gas to the surface, what they have to do is pump a mixture of toxic chemical cocktails underwater or underground at high speed, and then the natural gas shoots up to the surface. So the biggest problem with this is that when you pump the chemicals into the ground and it has the natural gas shoot up, there's no way of getting the chemicals out of the ground. Now, that wouldn't be so bad a problem if it wasn't for the fact that the chemicals are very toxic. Now, furthermore, maybe even then it wouldn't be that big of a problem, except that in a lot of documented cases, the fact that the chemicals have stayed in the ground and seeped their way through the ground and ended up in water supplies where people have gotten incredibly sick and in some cases had to move from their house, well, then you have a tremendous problem on your hand. So here are just some of the chemicals that are used in what's called hydraulic fracturing or fracking. Methanol. Now, methanol is found in antifreeze. It is a paint solvent and a vehicle fuel, and vapors from it can cause eye irritation, headache, and fatigue, and in high enough doses, it can be fatal. Benzene is used, which is listed as a hazardous air pollutant in the Clean Air Act and a contaminant in the Safe Drinking Water Act. Commonly found in gasoline, it's also known as a human carcinogen. Long-time exposure can cause cancer, bone marrow failure, or leukemia. Short-term effects include dizziness, weakness, headache, breathlessness, chest constriction, nausea, and vomiting. It also has effects on the central nervous system. Fracking companies have injected 11.4 million gallons of benzene into the ground between 2005 and 2009. Stay classy. Lead is also used. It's a carcinogen found in paint, building construction materials, and roofing joints. Hydrogen fluoride is used, which is found in rust removers, aluminum brighteners, and heavy-duty cleansers. It's listed as a hazardous air pollutant in the Clean Air Act, and it's incredibly corrosive and poisonous. Sulfuric acid is used, which is a carcinogen found in lead-acid batteries for cars, corrosive to all body tissue. Formaldehyde is used, which is, of course, a carcinogen found in embalming fluid. And by the way, this isn't even close to all of the chemicals that are used in fracking. If I had to go through all of them, there's over 600. So I'd be here all day. Now, the problem arises because they have no way of getting the chemicals out of the ground without using these. Well, they have no way of getting the chemicals out of the ground, period. But they have no way of getting the natural gas out of the ground without using the chemicals. So just to give you guys some more hardcore specific numbers here. According to ProPublica investigations, they found that fracking is the common thread in more than 1,000 cases of water contamination across 7 states, including dozens of cases of well failures in which the concrete or steel meant to protect aquifers cracked under high pressure. I've covered personal stories on the show before where certain people report having a cough that won't go away, losing their hair, getting incredibly sick, losing a tremendous amount of weight, and eventually leaving their houses because their water is completely contaminated with these different chemicals that are used in fracking. So the most disastrous part about all this, fracking is exempt from the Clean Water Act. And you want to know the name of the loophole it was given? The Halliburton loophole. They're the ones that lobbied for the loophole back under the George W. Bush administration, and they got the loophole. The loophole still exists under President Barack Obama, and it appears as if there's no end in sight. And they will still be allowed to frack despite the environmental damage and despite the substantive damage to the water supply and to a great number of people.